Hi to whoever may be watching this video right now. Glad you joined me. Today I'm going to be talking a little bit about Fort Wayne and why Fort Wayne is literally awesome. Now, I know there's a lot of people who think Fort Wayne's really boring or there's nothing to do, blah, 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 blah. I completely, completely disagree. I think the main reason Fort Wayne gets a rep like that is because we don't always reach out of our comfort zone or have people to share with us the cool things that we have to do in Fort Wayne, because there actually is so much. I know this is easy to forget. I always forget this. If you don't already know, Fort Wayne is like the second biggest city in all of Indiana. Being the second biggest city, I would think we have quite a bit to do. So that's what we're gonna be talking about in this video, is the cool things that you can do in Fort Wayne, new things to try, and why you should go out, even if it's out of your comfort zone a little bit. Go out, try something new, because I am a firm believer of it is what you make it to be. And even if your circumstances don't seem the best, like if you don't think Fort Wayne is the best and you think it's boring, just make the most out of it. It's too much to fit into one video. So I think I'm gonna make this episode one out of who knows how many episodes it'll turn out to be. But what they're gonna be is me bringing along my friends, going out, trying new things in Fort Wayne, showing you guys what you can do. Just have a fun, spontaneous adventure every once in a while. First local place I really wanted to try out, I had never been here, and neither of the friends I brought with me had been there either. I took along Emma and Reese, shout out you guys. We went to Biscuit Pottery. It's over on Coldwater. They basically have all sorts of pottery that you can paint. Literally so, so fun. I know it seems really random, but if you're like a creative, artsy person, or even if you suck at art, I'm not really the best at it, it's still fun to do just to try a new experience. And if your pot turns out really ugly, like mine did, and sorry, Reese, yours was not that pretty, it's still something to laugh about. And you can keep that pot on your shelf and always have that fun memory to look back on.
Okay, so we have our grand reveal of our stuff now. 3, 2, 1. So I did a Christmas theme, kind of. I'm not really a Picasso or Vincent Van Gogh, but something.
Mine is Plan R. There's about 5 different coats of paint on this around the whole thing. It took a little while, but I think we finally found the perfect match.
If y'all would have seen this before.
Should I do it?
Don't you dare. What did Emma do?
I did.
Emma was a little boring.
A wee little sunflower.
Wait, you? That's the only thing you did this whole time?
I wrote my name
on
the back.
I gotta show it to the camera.
No, you'll miss it. Okay, this is what I did.
Did you even color in the middle?
It's a gift for my friend, and she will really like this.
Did you even cover in the middle?
So I was thinking of her this whole time. We'll let the audience judge who has the best craft.